I wanted to bring on Mayor Liz Lempert. Mayor Lempert is the mayor of Princeton, and she, I know she's had to deal with this issue. And Liz, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. It's good to talk with you. Appreciate you being here.
Sure, it's my pleasure.
So, Liz, I've been hard on the municipal government in Princeton because I look at this and say, I do not for the life of me understand how this beam is not on full display in Princeton. What's your take on it? Why the delay? Why is this piece of our history that should be a memorial, at least to those eight lives that were lost in our town? Why is it under a tarp in a firehouse?
Yeah, well, I want to thank you for having me on and helping to explain what's going on. The background you gave is not really the full story. I think that's the manufactured controversy over this.
Okay, let's hear it.
It's really we want to create a memorial in a place in town that is appropriate and that will honor both those who lost their lives and also many of the first responders. We had our volunteer firefighters, mm-hmm. State Squad Police, rush to the scene from Princeton when they heard what was going on. So the original plan was to build a memorial on state-owned land that is actually a park commemorating the Revolutionary War, the Battle of Princeton. Mm-hmm. And the state did not give permission. They felt that having a memorial to 9/11, that was not the appropriate place for it because it had already, it would interfere with the sight lines and just the, I know you're from Princeton too. So
I live in Princeton, but I served for many years as a trustee for the Battlefield Preservation Committee. So I didn't know actually that this was the original site of it. Can I ask you though, Liz?
So we have a volunteer fire department. We're really lucky to have a volunteer fire department. We have consolidated all of our firefighters into one location now. But we're going to need to add another bay to the firehouse, most likely to.
But Liz, I want to go back to what you said. You said manufactured controversy. It is a real controversy that atheists are upset about the cross and they're presenting their case completely out of context. I never heard one of the atheists, and I've met them, we've interviewed them, and not one recognized that the reason those crosses were cut out of the beams, and not just the one that's sitting in the firehouse in Princeton, but many of them, hundreds, were done to put this on the stretcher carrying out remains of firefighters and cops. They seem to ignore that fact. Now, what do you say about that?
Well, that's just not factoring into how, our plans. And so, as I was saying, we're going to be having to do some work on our firehouse. It's a very appropriate place because of the first responders to honor their work and to incorporate the beam into the redesign of our firehouse and to create a memorial there. So, you know,
All right, but Liz, why is it not leaning somewhere where people can see it? Why is it not at City Hall right now? Why is it under a tarp? I'm just having a hard time understanding why it's still under a tarp.
Well, I think it's an important symbol, and it's in the care of our fire department. Those are the folks that were the first responders to 9/11 and to crises.
Liz, can I ask you to hold on 1 second? I have to take a quick break for traffic and weather, but I have a couple more questions for you. I'd like to just continue the conversation if you're okay with that. My question to you is this. You mentioned earlier manufactured controversy, and I know that people get very upset about issues like this and they go back and forth. My question to you is what do you believe? Because, you know, you're the elected mayor of the town, and I think it's important for people to understand what you believe. Do you believe this is a religious symbol that should be somehow covered and hidden? Or do you believe, like I do, that this happened on that day? It was done in a way to honor the first responders who were lost. And how is it not on display? Where do you stand on that?
Well, I mean, I feel honored that Princeton has this beam, and it's, I take our responsibility seriously to use it as part of a memorial that's that's going to be built the right way and do justice to the memory of people who lost their lives and to honor those who were the first responders that day.
Can you understand why people are so upset that it's sitting under a tarp, hidden? It feels what do you say of the lawsuit? Because the initial response you had when the media
There is no lawsuit.
No, I know that, but let me just ask you, Liz, the initial report that you gave, the interview you gave, was that you had the town attorney looking into it as to whether or not this violated some separation of church and state. I mean, your administration directly addressed the potential for a lawsuit. Is that has that gone away now? Is that not an issue any longer?
No, that's not the main issue right now. The main issue is trying to find an appropriate location. And, you know, it's as I mentioned earlier, the original location that was chosen was state land that is part of a park honoring the Revolutionary War. And there's a battle monument there. And interestingly, there was a Princeton group that formed in 1887 to build that monument. Mm-hmm. It wasn't completed until 1922. So it's, as you know...
Wait, 1887 to 1922. Are we going to have to wait 40 years for this beam? Are we going to have to wait 40 years for this beam to be displayed?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that memorials can take a while because people want to get them right. We want to get this one right. We want to do justice.
Liz, with all due respect, I don't think you need anything more than a beam from the World Trade Center with a cross that was etched in because that iron cross ended up on someone's stretcher, a first responder who died in the collapse. And I don't know that it needs any more explanation than that. And I guess the question to you is, why not walk into the firehouse and remove the tarp? Let the tarp be removed. People want to know that their elected officials care to honor what happened on that day and honor those fallen heroes. And I think it sounds so simple. I don't think it has to be overcomplicated. We're not talking about building a museum. We're talking about pouring some concrete and displaying a beam.
Well, I don't want to rush this. It's like, we want to do it right. We want to have it be a place where people come for generations and generations and remember what happened that day.
All right. Well, I'll tell you this, your office
in our minds,
your office is the perfect spot for it. That little plaza right in front of that multi-million-dollar structure that the taxpayers paid for, the new city hall, that plaza, I think, would be the perfect spot. Mayor Liz Lempert from Princeton, thank you for coming on New Jersey 101.5 with me. I appreciate your perspective. We don't agree. I think it's time to free the beam. But we will certainly stay in touch. And I do appreciate that you had the conversation with me this morning. You have a great weekend.
Keep you up to date.